Man, this is just looking like straw. I was so close to being like Pinterest chic. Hi guys, today I am going to be showing you how I use soap to set my brows in place. I did not come up with this hack or technique at all. This was used in old Hollywood and also a couple of girls on YouTube, including Desi and Pixie Wu, talked about this. So I watched a bunch of videos when I first discovered this hack, this process, which by the way blew my mind. I saw a lot of the videos and I decided to give it a try and share with you some of my tips and tricks that I've learned from just trying it out. Now, my brows are not perfect. I actually struggle with filling in my brows, which is why I wanted to try this hack in the first place. So if you're looking at my brows and you're like, they're not like the absolute most gorgeous brows in the world, I just want to say that your brows may look totally different than mine do after this process, because everybody's brows are different. And in just a couple seconds, you'll see what my brows look like without any makeup on, and you'll be shocked. So what you're gonna need for this hack is some soap, and I do have some clear Pears soap. Preferably, you'll want to use a clear soap of any brand, but that's just the one I'm using because that's the one a lot of videos recommended. The second thing you're gonna need is a spoolie, and I'm linking everything down below, including the makeup I'm wearing. So if you're curious, everything is down below, but you're just gonna need a spoolie, and you're also going to need a water bottle to spray down your soap. And as far as filling in your brows, you're gonna want to use whatever you're normally using. However, I will be talking about what products I found work better on soapy brows, and some products definitely work better than others, including pomade. So I will be using a pomade today to fill in my brows, which is not actually my preferred product to use on my brows because it's really hard for me to use pomades for some reason. I always struggle with them, but I found that that's the best product to use on top of soapy brows. But if you prefer to use something else, you can always try that. Just know that it may not take to your soapy brows. All right, I guess with that being said, let's jump into the application. Make sure to like this video and to subscribe to my channel for more future videos, because I produce about 3 a week on good weeks. I'm trying to go up to 5. We'll see where that goes. But regardless, like, subscribe. And with that being said, let's jump into the next section. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. Okay, so the first step is taking your soap and then spraying it down with water. And I'm actually not even going to use water because I am missing my water spray bottle. So instead, I'm going to be bougie. I'm going to be using this facial spray, which I actually reviewed and really like. I don't recommend you guys wasting essentially fancy sprays like this, but again, I don't know where my water bottle went. Then I'm going to take my spoolie and I'm going to run the spoolie against the soap, just like this. And then your spoolie is going to get kind of gross like this. Your spoolie is going to have all this gunky thing on it. If you do have a foundation that's like darker than your skin tone, or you just don't want to get rid of any coverage, make sure to not like brush above or below the brow. Like, make sure to stick to the brow area, because otherwise you're going to be wiping some of that makeup off. And I've done that before. I would go into work with like light colored line around my brow because I would like wipe all of the makeup around it. So just don't do that. Don't do what I do sometimes. Now, the trick is also to not apply too much soap, because I've done that before and my coworker was looking at me and goes, "You've got something in your brows." And then I realized it was soap. This is looking quite crazy, and you don't have to brush them up like the magazines do it to models if you don't want to, but this is the gist of it. You're essentially defining all of the brows and setting them in place, whatever that means for you, whether it's up or down or sideways, whatever that is. So for me, I like to brush them up right here, but then slowly transition them to like sideways, because that's just how they grow for me. And you can twist the spoolie so that you don't have to go up and down as much. You can just kind of like keep the spoolie in place but still have each hair get enough of the product. And this basically maximizes and defines each brow hair. So if you don't have too many of those, then you know how precious each one is, and this helps you, like I said, maximize each one. Now, I keep saying sparse brows, but this is also great if you have bushy brows and they're unruly and they're just, you know, growing everywhere, every which way. So you can use this technique to set them in place and redirect them to however you want to. All right, so this is it for the soap, but now it's time to fill in the brows. I found that the best product to use when you have soapy brows never thought I would say soapy brows, but here we are, is pomade, like brow pomade, because that's something that can glide over and stick to that area and not budge. I've tried powders, I've tried pencils, I've tried liquid pens. Things work okay, but not great, because soapy brows are essentially like this waxy consistency brow texture that a lot of products don't want to stick to, and pomades are the best. However, you might not be a fan of pomades. Like, I'm not a huge fan of pomades, but then I have those days where I use a pomade and I'm like, how come I don't use this more often? And then other days I'm like, that's why I don't use this more often. Okay, so I'm going to take the pomade and I'm going to stroke the hairs in, but kind of not. This is not going to be like hair stroking tutorial, because quite frankly I'm still trying to figure out how to master that. It's very difficult, especially when you have sparse brows that just, you know, are missing whole chunks. But you don't have to do that if you don't want to. You can just literally fill in your brows as normal, as long as your product takes to soapy brows. But my technique is kind of like in between of regular filling in your brows and stroking the brow hairs in, which is where I go with the direction of how my hairs grow, but then I'm not too careful with individual strokes. So let me just show you. Just brushing them through, because again, with soapy brows, I keep saying soapy brows and you're probably like, what the heck are you saying? But with soapy brows, it's very easy to cake the product on, like no matter what product. Once you have the soap on there, it just seems to attract a ton of product. I'm gonna take a little bit of the foundation that I've used earlier and just clean up the underneath area right here. Okay, so this is the before and the after with the filling. Okay, so both of my brows are filled in now. Okay, so if I feel like I have done too much with the pomade, I would take a dampened Q-tip and run it through the brows. Again, don't run it like high up here because you're gonna take some makeup off. I mean the foundation, because you're gonna try to take the brow makeup off. Okay, I think my brows are done. They're not perfect. They're never gonna be perfect, but that is the essence of how you use soap on brows. I guess let me zoom you in to show you the brow texture up close, but that's essentially what you're getting. And it's basically your brows look like your brows but bushier, because you see hair texture more so than you would without the soap. Even if your brows are thin, they're gonna look bushier, a little hairier, which is a good thing. Most of the time when you say something is hairy, it's not usually the greatest thing in the world, but for brows it is. With soap, your brows will look a little hairier in a good way. Alright, so this is my brows up close. You can see that the soap does leave a little bit of a texture. I mean, I guess you need that residue, because otherwise soap would not be there and would not be doing its job of holding and shaping the brow hairs. But you do have that texture. They're like tacky. You can move them. They're not like hard set. See, like they're moving around. But you do have that like texture on them that you may not love. Okay, so I hope you guys see the difference between the brows before and the brows after, and there is a difference. And I do think that soap can make your brows look really set in place and bushy looking and fuller and just more, I'm gonna say, model like I hope you know what I mean, you know, like those models with like super bushy brushed brows. Like, soap can help you achieve that look, and it is a cheap way of doing it. You don't need anything fancy. You literally just need some water, a spoolie, which you probably already have, and then a bar of soap. And I will link the one I used down below, which is like the clear one, which I think is probably the best one to use. But you can pretty much use any bar of soap, at least to like try it out. So it's a minimum cost product situation. However, it's not really convenient, because you do have to have all these products and then you have to like spray it and then use it, and soap does get a little like wet and gooey, and you have to let it air so it doesn't get moldy. And it's not the most easy boom 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 done process. This is a first world problem. I totally understand that. Please know that I mean that wholeheartedly, but it's still not the easiest, most efficient process, especially if you're trying to get ready in the morning and like get out the door. Thank you guys so much for all of your sweet comments and the support I get from you guys. It means the absolute world to me. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any future video requests, then leave those in the comment section below. I always jot them down and try to get to most of them as soon as I can. There are a couple that I'm trying to get to still, but I'm sure I will very soon. Anyway, I love you all. Thanks so much, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.